Hello everyone, we are talking about Moodle today and when I say Moodle, this dynamic bundle of different resources, application tools, plugins is provided to us not just as a content management system. We don't just manage the contents, we actually develop a course, we deliver the course, we conduct assessments, we do interactions also. So Moodle is primarily a software which is installed on the clouds, whether it is on your own server or some service providers like Genomio. So today we are referring to genomio.com. They provide us free space to host our Moodle site. So we are making a website which works not just as a content management website, which also has got the scope of running courses. Virtual classroom is created primarily. So what you do on Genomio, we all know, we have been familiar with it, those who have been using Moodle, that we select a site name which is hosted on Genomio, we give our email address, and then we select the language, accepting the conditions, we create the site. So the site is being created. A significant change which has happened when Genomio shifted from free for all to limited usage. Now, it used to be free, it is still free, but there are certain limitations. Now, let's go to this one. These plans were never there, but now they have launched them in the last month when Moodle 3.9 came, and they have seen big humongous potential of expanding into Moodle hosting as well, because everybody wants to conduct online classes these days, they want to host their courses, they want to have virtual classroom online. So they had this opportunity to come for business, so they have done it, like as everybody does these days, for the sake of market and their own growth. Now, in the free account that we'll be creating, we get 500 registered users, 50 concurrent users who are active, who stay active, and then that way 50 courses we can have. 2 GB of storage is there. We used to have an unlimited one, sort of a 10 GB storage was there, but now we only get 2 GB. And 100 MB upload file size limit means one file can be a maximum of 100 MB. Email support they give us, and then ads will be displayed on the site. So this is how it is in Moodle. On Genomio, the face that I'm sharing with you is this one, virtual teaching, that was made before they launched 3.9. Now there are two platforms, Moodle Cloud and Genomio. Both of them have provided us free hosting. Virtualteaching.genomio.com that you can see, and the second one is teacherperv.genomio.com. These two have been hosted on Genomio. On Moodle Cloud, there is another site by the name of eclavier.moodlecloud.com, but we are not talking about Moodle Cloud. They are on 3.8.2 and they are going to upgrade it to 3.9, of course, but there are limitations there, 50 users only, and then certain more limitations. But Genomio gives you more, you say, scope and user rights than Moodle Cloud, but even Genomio has got these limitations. Let's see what are the differences which are there. This is Moodle 3.5, which was earlier available to all of us for free, and today we are going to talk about the things which have been available when we were using virtualteaching.genomio.com site is there, and we were using 3.5. So we are going to site administration. The difference will be in the plugins. Actually, the interface is all though the same, it's all same that way. Some new features and some polishing has appeared. Now the plugins, let's go to manage activities and see what are the plugins which were earlier available. You can see these are the plugins. We can see attendance, a significant thing which was there in 3.5, free of cost. Attendance plugin is available to everyone who is using Moodle and is hosting on their own server, means the hosting is your own, so there's no dependence on anyone. So attendance is there. And these are the plugins. You can see so many plugins were there. Glossary was there, that way JClick was there, Jitsi was also there, and these are the plugins. Most of them have been activated. Suppose we go to a course and I can show you what are the plugins that I have been using. We are going to a course. Suppose we go to this one. Suppose we go to public speaking, and then we'll see what are the courses which are available along with the plugins. So we turn the editing on and we'll see what is the list of the activities we can add to it. So here we go. you can see these are the plugins which have been activated through Manage Activities. Earlier, there used to be this option that you could activate the plugins from the backend in the site administration. So these are the plugins. Let's go to another one. The other one is actually the one which has been made recently, just 3 days back. It was made and it is on 3.9. So this is Moodle 3.9 that you see, and the other one is Moodle 3.5. Both are hosted on Genomeo. Genomeo has provided hosting for it free of cost. So we are going to plugins available in 3.9 by Genomeo. So you can see there's no attendance here. There's no JClick. A very limited number of plugins are there, and all of them are active also. Like only this assignment 2.2 is disabled, otherwise most of them are available and are being provided. Here you can see, suppose we go here on the site home and we can give it a try, and we can find out whether we can like add certain plugins. So we'll turn the editing on. We'll just see a list for now which are available. All the ones which have been provided in the backend in the site administration manage activities on 3.9 version on Genomeo, they are all visible here. You can see this is the difference, and here is the difference. These are the ones which are there on 3.5, and they have said that till May 2021, next year, till then they are going to provide support for 3.5, and after that they'll discontinue it. So I have got a site on 3.5 version on Genomeo. So before that I'm supposed to take a backup of it, and because after that these things won't be working. You can see attendance is there, and these many features have been there which were available and I had activated. I could activate, but now the features have been limited. Now, if you have purchased virtual hosting from them, or you have launched your own Moodle site on your own server, then you can go for any number of plugins. But if you are making a site on Genomeo, only these plugins are available to you. You cannot make use of all the plugins. So this limitation has come in the free version on Genomeo. So these are the ones that I had activated. I'll show you a bigger list now of all those plugins which were there in 3.5 Genomeo. Just as a recap of the topic that we were doing today, manage activities, and these are the plugins. So friends, this is the difference. These many plugins were there, and in the free one, they are just providing these. So Genomeo has limited the usage. So the recommendation is you purchase your own domain, you purchase your own hosting, and then you launch your Moodle site. That is the best one. But for now, if you are not hunting for attendance, if you're not hunting for those interactive plugins which were there, like even if you can see real-time quiz was there and so many other were there, you can see the difference. JClick was there, Jitsi was there for online meetings. Here you get H5P for interactive things. I don't see the big blue button here. It means, like, for attendance, we communicated with Genomeo, and yesterday I got a reply that if you purchased the pro version of it and you have paid for virtual hosting with them, only then that plugin will be provided to you. In the free one, they don't provide it. So these are the limitations in 3.9, but still Genomeo is supporting us, giving us free hosting of our courses. So it is better. Even if with advertisements, you can do pretty well on Genomeo. You can launch your own Moodle site. You can offer your courses as well. So 3.5 moves to 3.9 on Genomeo. And that is the big help we have got from Genomeo in the form of free hosting. So here it is, your Moodle site on 3.9. Remember, all the plugins which are available can be seen by going to Site Administration, Plugins and Manage Activities, and all the plugins are by default visible when you are going to opt for them under Activity and Resources. So this is what we had for now. 3.5 moves to 3.9 on Genomeo.